much, Rachel, for agreeing to be interviewed today. I really appreciate it, and I appreciate you signing the informed consent. And I want to let you know, I'm going to pull that up, so if I don't, if I'm not looking directly at you, that's the reason for it, but I do want to make sure we go over the informed consent one more time, just to make sure that you understand what exactly we are going over today. Is that okay?
Yes.
Thank you. So in the informed consent, it said that you were agreeing to be interviewed by myself, an undergraduate student at East Central University, for interviewing techniques class, and that you understood that the interview will be reviewed by my course instructor and videotaped, and that this is for training purposes only. So this is not a counseling session or the initiation of a helping relationship, but I also want you to understand that your comments and interactions during this interview will not influence my grade in any way. And I also want to make sure that you understand that what you say here stays here, but I am being held to confidentiality limitations. So if you disclose that you are going to harm yourself or others, or some form of child abuse or elder abuse, I am mandated by the state to report that. And that this videotape will not be cut, but will be destroyed after my assignment is complete, and that you can end this interview session anytime that you wish. Does that sound agreeable to you?
Yes, that sounds agreeable to me.
Thank you very much. And so today, we just want to go over what has brought you here. Do you mind sharing a little bit about what's going on with your family lately?
Well, I have been dating my current boyfriend for 2 years. He lives in his own home, and I live in my own home with my children. And my daughter, she is 18, and my son is 15. And so I am ready to get married, and we're engaged, and I'm ready to combine my household with my boyfriend.
Wow, congratulations.
Thank you. So that means I'll be moving out of, or my son and I will be moving out of our home and moving into my boyfriend's home.
And so your daughter will not be moving with you?
No, she will not be moving with us. She is going to be staying here with her boyfriend, and hopefully, I say hopefully, taking over the full responsibilities and maintenance and bills of this home.
Wow. What do you think that her strengths are when it comes to taking on that kind of responsibility?
She works full-time, 6 days a week. She's a hard worker, but this with the pandemic going on, her hours have been cut because she works in a restaurant. She's a waitress.
Did you say what your, I don't mean to interrupt, I'm sorry, but did you say what your timeline was for when you guys are moving in together?
We don't have a specific timeline, but in our minds, we always thought by this summer. We're getting married in September, so we kind of want to live with each other a little bit, I guess, before we get married.
Right.
So this kind of, with everything going on, it's kind of put a damper on plans that we have.
So with her hours being cut, has her pay been cut?
Yes, they have. They've kind of reworked what she's getting paid. She's getting paid $10 an hour right now. So it's like $50 a day that she's making. But she would make more than that in tips as being a waitress.
Right.
And then her boyfriend, he is currently working, but his hours have kind of been cut due to this stuff. And then he thought his father had was kind of restricted on going, you know, to work, because if you suspect that someone, you know, in your family has it, then you stay home until you get the result, you know, the negative result.
Right.
So, which we were all scared in our house, you know, with, because he lives here with us too, and thinking that he was exposed by his father and that he'd been at our home. And so it was kind of, you know, nerve-wracking for a couple of days until we got the result.
Wow. Congratulations. I'm glad to find out that the results were negative. What a scary thing to happen.
Yes, yes.
So what do you think, as far as her taking over the responsibility of the home that you have now, what do you think that she's going to struggle with the most?
I think she's going to struggle with realizing that mom does a lot of things, not only financially, but environmentally in this home. Just going from letting the dog out, feeding the animals, and cooking, cleaning, you know, and especially the bills. They just don't realize it at this time.
Have you started giving her some more responsibilities as far as those chores go, or have you guys started like incrementally increasing the amount of responsibility? Like, what stage would you say that you're at as far as her taking over?
I feel like we were making progress with financial things in a way, but then we kind of, you know, digressed like over the Christmas holiday.
Mm-hmm.
It was almost like, oh, hey, it's Christmas, you know, we shouldn't have to pay anything, you know, kind of a mentality. And so it hasn't picked back up. So them two, they are not currently helping at all financially at this time. So hopefully that they're saving money, you know, and that they have money. With the dishes, I have stopped washing any cups in the house because they love to use cups. So I went on strike and I am not washing any cup in this house because I have one cup I use and I clean it each time.
That's a very interesting
strike. Yeah. And, you know, I kind of stopped buying so many groceries, you know, where it wasn't just so free for all, you know, snacks anytime.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, with everything going on, I've had, you know, I'm eating at home all the time. So I've had to buy more groceries and snacks and stuff like that. So
what are the...
I think we went down. I'm not sure.
You what?
It kind of paused. But what'd you say?
What would you say are the shared responsibilities in the house? So I know that you stated that you do most of the environmental stuff, so like taking the dogs out or buying groceries and cooking and stuff like that. So what responsibilities does your daughter and her boyfriend have in the home?
Doing their own laundry, maybe?
Yeah.
But I still fold, put away in their room, you know, just because if I want to do some of my laundry, I have to clear out the washer and dryer.
Right.
So,
do you feel like you're going to have a hard time when you do move out? Do you feel like you're going to have a hard time allowing them to take over? Or do you feel like there's going to be a period where you have to step back in sometimes?
My plan is to just throw my hands up in the air and like, it's on you. But this, you know, this is my home. And so I don't want stuff to be destroyed or, you know, or not kept up. So hopefully I don't have to come back and like spray for bugs or, you know, stuff like that.
On a scale of 1 to 10, what would you say is your feelings as far as your daughter being able to handle that level of responsibility at this point in her life?
I feel about a 7, because I know that know, my expectations are way higher than what, you know, young couples' expectations are of a home and a house. And so I hope that it'll be easier on them not having to live up to my standards. But then I'm thinking my daughter has pretty high standards like I do. So I'm hoping that it doesn't create, you know, more tension between them. Because she's going to get tired of it not being picked up, you know, or done her way.
Right. Do you feel like your son is ready to make the move with you as far as moving in with your fiancé? Do you feel like he's ready to make that move?
He is hesitant because he's, you know, just happy in his little room with his Wi-Fi and everything. And we're actually moving like 6 miles out into the country. And so Wi-Fi is not as fast where we're moving. It's even a different internet service. So, and then he says that he hopes that he can have a lock on his door because my boyfriend has 2 young daughters and he doesn't like little kids, he says. So, but he'll go anywhere with, you know, where his mom is, so.
But so he's, I didn't mean to interrupt you.
No, it's all right.
I was just going to say, so his 2 biggest issues with the move will be the Wi-Fi speeds and then privacy, a lock on the store.
Yes, yes.
So.
But I'm confident that he will do fine as well.
Well, I know as a teenage boy, the Wi-Fi speed, especially with the amount of video games that kids play today, that can be a great concern to them because the games won't run.
Right.
So.
Yeah, and that's his whole life. Like, gaming is his life other than, you know, basketball. So it'll be a trial and error, you know.
Do you have a plan as far as how you're going to take the initial steps in your move?
We've talked about it. So his daughters have separate rooms, so they will be joining rooms, and we'll have to remodel one of the rooms. There's like owls and stuff on wallpaper on the walls and stuff, and so we're gonna, you know, take that down, rip up the carpet, and repaint and everything. And so I guess it's just when we have time and extra money to kind of put that plan in place. I think that will kind of be the initiator. Like, hey, it's time and we're doing this, you know, so.
Well, Rachel, I wanted to say thank you so much for participating in the interview today. I appreciate your candor as far as what's going on in your life. And